In the last video, we established a reasonable upper bound on the one-year forward settlement price of gold. And we established that at 1150, which is essentially the spot price plus the borrowing rate to borrow $1,000 plus the carrying cost of the gold. What I want to do in this video is to think of a reasonable lower bound. And to do that, let's imagine a world where instead of the forward settlement price being 1150, let's imagine a world where the forward settlement price is, well, let's just say it is $1,050. So it's still higher than the spot price. But let's think about it from the point of view of someone who wants to hold gold in a year. And let's say that you're that someone, and right now you have $1,000 that you want to use to give you gold so that you have, and you want to hold the gold for the long term. So you have two options here. You could just buy gold now, buy 1 ounce with your $1,000 right now. And then when you go forward a year from then, you're going to have that 1 ounce of gold, 1 ounce, plus you're going to have to pay the carrying cost, the safety deposit box and the insurance on the gold. So you're going to have 1 ounce of gold minus $50. That's what you're going to have to pay. The other option, you say, hey, look, instead of putting my $1,000 into gold right now, let me put my $1,000 into a risk-free bond. Into a risk-free bond. So risk-free bond. And at the same time, agree to be the buyer on the one-year forward settlement, on the one-year forward contract. So I'm agree to be the buyer at what, at 1050. So if you go forward a year, your $1,000 risk-free bond is going to give you 5% interest a year. So you're going to have $1,050. That's just the interest on your bond. And then you can use that to go and buy the gold, which you already locked in the price by agreeing to be the buyer on the forward contract. So then you buy the gold. And in both situations, you end up with an ounce of gold a year from now, starting with your $1,000. But in this situation, you just have an ounce of gold, and you didn't have to pay any carrying costs. In this situation, you have the ounce of gold, and you did have to pay carrying costs. So clearly, any rational person, assuming they're buying the gold for the long term, would want to do this situation. They save $50 over the course of the year. So really, the rational price, if this were to happen, everyone would want to be the buyers over here. So now we're talking about a 1050 price. That's right over here. This was a price in the last example. So everyone would want to be the buyer on the futures contract or the forward contract. So that would increase the price over there. And you'd have less buyers on the spot contract. So that would decrease the price over there. So in general, this price seems too low. And the price at which people would be neutral is if this price was $50 higher, because then it becomes completely equivalent. So a rational lower bound, given all of this, would have been a price of $1,100. $1,100. And in general, just going back to the last video, a rational upper bound will be the spot price plus the carrying costs and the rate at which someone could borrow money. And a rational lower bound will be the spot price plus the risk-free interest rate and the carrying cost. So in general, the only difference between those upper and lower bound is this rate and this rate, this rate, and this rate. And so if these were the same, the rational price would be the same. So if these were both 10%, then the rational price would be $1,150. If these were both 5%, the rational price, the upper and the lower bound, would have been $1,100.